Welcome to the introduction to VP-6000. This video covers the functionality of VP-6000, connections on the back of the unit, and how to navigate the web interface. A VP-6000 is a video processor that accepts video signals and performs refinement functions including keying and video mixing. A single VP-6000 processor can control one display or multiple displays depending on the internal card configuration and is typically triggered using Display Studio scripts. The main components of a VP-6000 consists of activity indicators and both inputs and outputs for SDI and DisplayPort. The back of a VP-6000 has four mini BNC input connectors that allow for seamless switching and layering of these video inputs, along with a mini BNC output for a confidence feed. The DisplayPort input is used to accept the Daktronics DMP-8000. Upon boot up, activity lights on the back of the 6000 will flash from gold to blue, cyan, and then green to indicate hardware initialization is complete and the 6000 is ready for use. The boot-up sequence typically takes around 3 minutes. After boot-up, the user interface can be accessed via a web browser on the same network as the VP-6000. Access the interface by entering the IP address of the VP-6000. Once logged on, you will be taken to the dashboard of the VP-6000. In the top right is the user icon, which expands to show icons to update, help, and about pages. Update is used to update the firmware on the VP-6000. Help provides a manual for the VP-6000, and About shows the current firmware version and support line for Daktronics. The top left menu icon expands to show icons for the dashboard, configuration, monitoring, calibration, test patterns, and configuration backup pages. The tiles shown are interactive, and clicking on a tile will take you to the configuration page for that tile. The most commonly used tiles are the identification, network, inputs, and time tiles. The most commonly used page is the monitoring page. The network tile is used to set the IP address, subnet mask, and gateway of the VP-6000. If changes are made here, select Save, and then you will need to log back in to the VP-6000 using the new IP address after rebooting to continue using the web interface. The identification tile is used to configure the name of the VP-6000 and the mode of the VP-6000. The mode can be set to primary or backup. The inputs tile is used to set the input format for the SDI and DisplayPort inputs. To set the SDI input format, select the drop-down bar and select from 1080p60, 1080p30, 1080i60, or 720p60, and for DisplayPorts, type in the height and width of the frame size. Once set, select Save to apply changes. Please consult a Daktronics technician prior to changing the configuration of the video inputs. The time tile is used to set the time zone for the VP-6000. It's important that the time zone of your VP-6000 matches your DMP-8000s, Venus Control Suite, and Show Control computers to ensure communication between all devices. The monitoring page is used to monitor the inputs of the VP-6000 to confirm if a signal is being received on each input. From here, you can also monitor the output card to ensure a signal is being sent out to the display. The remaining tiles and pages are used by Daktronics personnel to set up, test, and calibrate the VP-6000s and should be used only when directed by a Daktronics technician. This concludes the introduction to VP-6000. Continue on to other videos to learn more about your Daktronics control equipment.